How's it going, everybody? Today we are going to look at how to change laptop thermal paste.
This video is brought to you by my personal pocketbook, so if you'd like to help me out, like, subscribe, and check out my Patreon page so I can make more videos like this one.
So one of the first videos I've ever created on this YouTube channel was how to change CPU thermal paste on a desktop, and it's become one of my most popular videos, and it was kind of fun to go back and watch it, even though it's only, I don't know, 3 or 4 months old, and to see how awkward it was.
Today, I learned how to apply thermal paste. Now let me show you how it's done.
That was like some kind of creepy health teacher or something. Oh. Okay, so if you clicked on this video, you're probably interested in how to change the laptop thermal paste. So that's what we're gonna do. I have this Lenovo laptop. This is this old beast I've had for 6 or 7 years, and I had never changed the thermal paste on this laptop, and I noticed it was getting quite hot. So this is something that's quite easy to do. It can be a bit taunting, or not taunting, but it can be a bit intimidating at first, but it's actually quite easy. So I'm gonna show you how to change the thermal paste step-by-step, make it really easy for you. So why you might want to change the thermal paste on a laptop is because of thermal throttling. So when a laptop gets old, especially after about 3 or 4 years, and granted that the thermal paste was applied properly in the factory, what's gonna happen, it's gonna dry out and it's gonna have a harder time transferring that heat from the actual CPU and the GPU onto that heatsink and then out of the computer. So when it gets too hot, laptops have thermal targets, it's actually gonna thermal throttle, and that's gonna cause the computer to slow down. So if you have experienced some kind of slowdowns in your computer, especially when you're gaming or doing anything, or you feel like the computer's getting physically hot, that's gonna happen anyways, but if you feel it's getting really warm, and maybe this is a good idea. So what you're gonna need is 99% isopropyl alcohol, something to clean the dye with. I like to use coffee filters, they're lint-free. So any kind of lint-free thing, paper towels work fine too. Cotton swabs are something I like to use, so if you have some of those, they are very helpful for this type of thing. You're gonna need your favorite thermal paste. I'm gonna be using thermal grizzly in this case. And lastly, you're gonna need the tools to disassemble your laptop. So the first thing you need to do is take off the bottom of your laptop. My laptop makes this easy with screws holding on the bottom. Yours likely will be different than this. So just look for any kind of teardown video on YouTube or any other place. You might need specific tools for this because sometimes they have plastic that kind of clips into itself. So you might need some kind of special tools to take apart your laptop. But if you have an older laptop, it's likely just disassembled with screws and it's gonna be pretty straightforward. Once you have the bottom off, you're gonna have to locate the screws that are holding on the heatsink and remove those. So again, I recommend following the specific teardown for your laptop, mainly because there might be a few things that are a bit different than mine that you have to remove. Like for example, mine was quite straightforward. I just had to remove a few screws. There weren't any fans plugged in that I had to remove. There weren't anything like that out of the ordinary. It's very simple. Once you've removed the heatsink, locate the CPU, and if you have a dedicated graphics chip, find that as well. So at this point, you're ready to clean the dies. What I like to do is use the coffee filter or whatever you wanted to use to wipe towards the center of the die, being careful not to make a mess like I did on the CPU. I actually got some of that crud in places I didn't want to. That's not really an issue. It's not like it's gonna be necessarily bad for the computer, but it's just kind of a pain in the butt to have to clean up. You can see here, I did a better job with that technique on the GPU die. Once those are looking shiny and clean, go ahead and do the same to the heatsink. And at this point, you should be ready to apply your thermal paste. So I didn't talk too much about what specific thermal paste you would want to use. Like I said, I'm using thermal grizzly in this case. You can go on YouTube, go online, look for reviews. And I think in the past, I might've mentioned that it doesn't really matter which thermal paste you use. I was specifically talking about desktops. When it comes to a laptop, you really do want the best because a laptop has these thermal targets, right? And if you can make it as cool as possible, wicking away that heat as best as possible, that's gonna be the best in this case. So the best one I had in my drawers, I'm sorry, I'm not hiding thermal paste in my pants. The best one I had on hand was not thermal grizzly. So take your thermal paste and apply it. I like to use a healthy amount. This is not like applying CPU paste to a desktop CPU. You want the entire die covered. It's much like if you were changing the paste on a GPU. Well, literally it is a GPU, but you want that entire die covered. So if you want to, if you have a credit card or something like that, if your thermal paste came with a little spatula, I know some people have a lot of spatulas. You can go ahead and spread it to make sure that it's completely covered. In my case, I used the P method on the GPU and made a line for the CPU. I'm completely confident that those are gonna be completely covered, so you can do that if you like. Now you wanna replace the heatsink. Try to place it directly straight down. You don't wanna smudge that thermal paste and make a mess under there. So just try to line it up with those screw holes, put it down, put a little bit of pressure on there, and just replace the screws. Tighten those up, and that should be good to go. Lastly, reassemble the bottom of the laptop. Again, this is basically reverse. If you have screws, put the screws back in. If you have a more snap-in type laptop, this is probably gonna be quite easy for the most part. So just go ahead and do that, make sure everything's in place. And at this point, you're good to go, that's it. Your laptop is back together, make sure it turns on, make sure everything works, and check out the thermals and see if you had any issues before, see if they're fixed, see what kind of gaming performance you have at this point. I did a few tests myself, which I'm gonna share in a different video on this topic. And I hope this has been a learning experience for you. It definitely had been one for me. I'm someone who's had laptops in the past, many different laptops. This is the longest one I've had, and I bought it originally to use as kind of an editing rig, a gaming rig, while I was away at work. And it's been doing quite well, but I did notice recently that it was getting very hot when I was using it for any kind of gaming type application. So I thought it was a good experiment to do and a learning experience for me. I definitely enjoyed the experience and to learn how easy it actually was. So I hope this video has been helpful for you. Please leave a like, it really helps the channel. Subscribe if you want more content like this. This has been Tech Literate. My name is Nick. Thank you for watching.